What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying Windows 11 23H2 because on the last video, we did how to deploy Windows 11 23H2 within the new Proxmox lab that I built with you guys. It is time for me to demo the deployment, so let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is create a virtual machine within our Proxmox lab. Well, that's what I did. This is the virtual machine that I created, ID number 400 with the name of test.btnhd.edu. From here, I had to make a couple of changes. So I went into options. Within options, I selected the boot order and I clicked on the edit button. Now to change the order is pretty simple. We're going to select number 3, click on it, hold it, and we're going to drag it all the way to the top to make it number 1. We're going to click on okay. Now it is time for us to deploy. We're going to start up our virtual machine. We're going to click on F12 and Pixie boot and select our task sequence. All right, so you saw the video, you saw the quick demo, and at the very end, you saw this. Failed to run the task sequence. So I had to do some troubleshooting within my SCCM, and this is what I basically did to get my deployment, to go out successfully. So the first thing that I did was I went into my domain controller. I basically launched the Active Directory sites and services, and I made sure that within the subnets folder, my subnet where I'm going to be pixie booting all these virtual machines was present. If it's not added, if you have additional subnets that you're going to be pixie booting devices to deploy your operating system, make sure you have it here. That's the first thing that I did. I went into my SCCM server. I clicked on software. And within software, I double clicked on the operating systems folder. And I went into boot images. From here, I selected my boot image x64. I right-clicked on it, and I went into update distribution point. I checked off reload the boot image, and I clicked on next. A nice little summary, I click next here. It's reloading the boot image, and once everything is done, you're going to get this. Click on close. Give it some time. The content status will change to in progress and eventually going to change to success. I waited a couple of minutes, I went again, I pixie boot, and I still got the problem. So I went back into this section here, and I right-clicked on our x64 boot image. I went into properties, and within properties, I went into the content locations tab, and I selected my site server, which is my SCCM server. I clicked on redistribute, and I clicked OK, and I clicked OK here, and again, right there on the lower right-hand side, content status should change to in progress. Give it some time, it should change to success. I went again, I pixie boot my virtual machine ID 400, same problem. So I went back into the SCCM server, and from here I went into administration. And within administration, I opened up the site configuration folder and I went into servers and site system roles. I selected my primary site, which is my SCCM server, and I selected underneath the site system roles distribution point. I right-clicked on it and I went into properties. Now I gave it a description, and you guys don't really need to do this, but I gave it a description, and from the general tab, I enabled and configured the branch cache for the distribution point. So I just gave it a check mark. I clicked on apply. And then from here, I went into the boundary groups tab. I clicked on add and I gave it a check mark because that's the only boundary that I have right now. And I clicked OK and I clicked apply and then I clicked OK. Bam. This right here, all the stuff that I did actually gave me a successful deployment, which you guys are going to catch right now. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and don't go anywhere because I'm going to show you the demo with the successful deployment of Windows 11 23H2. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.